Okay, students, and now let's move on to the second problem. In second problem, there are three actually, but they are quite simple. But I will explain first and second one. Third one, it's similar to this, you can manage yourself. Okay, so second main, first one. What they say, examine is Rolle's theorem is applicable for the following function. Okay, actually, that second part is not necessary, so just leave it. Okay, and to be frank, first and second problem are so far not being given, sir. Then why we have to study? We have to study for the sake of MCQs. In objective levels, we need them. So far, those kind of problems never been given in the board examination. Okay, so a polynomial function usually will be given to us. What they have given us, f of x equal to greatest integer of x. You have studied in types of function, greatest integer of x, and they said x belongs to closed interval 5 comma 9. Okay, what is that? It's not a polynomial this time. So I want to check whether it's going to be continuous. I will tell you two methods. Actually, the first method is graphical method. If you remember the graph, something like this. I know most of you remember the graph of this. Correct, right? Like this, the graph. Okay, so this will be 1, this will be 2, okay, and this will be 3, this will be 4. Look here, it is between 1 and 2, what I am going to consider. Look here, it is continuous everywhere between 1 and 2, but it is not continuous at 1, not continuous at 2, because see, there is a break here. I told you, if the first condition is not getting satisfied, don't check the remaining at all. Okay, and what is the conclusion for this problem? F of x is equal to greatest integer of x is not continuous at integral point. Integral point means it's not continuous at 1 because there's a break here. It's not continuous at 2, it's not continuous at 3, it's not continuous at 4, it's not continuous at 5. Generally, you can give a conclusion. Okay, greatest integer of x is not continuous at any integral point. Therefore, it is not continuous in the closed interval 5 comma 9 also. If it's not continuous, not differentiable. If it's not differentiable at all, no need to check the further condition. No need to check f of a equal to f of b. Still, I will help you in finding f of a equal to f of b. What does f of a means? F of a means f of 5. Greatest integer of 5. Greatest integer of 5 will be 5. Okay, and f of 9? F of 9 will be greatest integer of 9 will be equal to 9. What you notice? They are not equal. F of 5 is not equal to f of 9. Actually, no need to check this because it's not continuous. Once it's not continuous, it's not differentiable. No need to check this actually. Still, I'm just trying to help you how to say the third condition is not verified. Okay, the same method, students, if you have a problem in understanding this, please open the topic from the types of functions in first year. Okay. Please go through and refer some examples, then you will be able to understand. I hope the graphical version is quite easier to solve such kind of problems. So to this one, you have to just give a statement. Greatest integer of x is not continuous at any integral points. Therefore, it is not continuous. Once it is not continuous, it is not differentiable. Also, f of 5 is not equal to f of 9. Just see. I didn't even check the value of, because see, it's not differentiable means how can I find f dash of c? Not possible. So that's a way to solve the second problem of this. Based on the same method, just repeat the same thing what you will go to write it here. F of x equal to greatest integer of x, only the interval is changed to minus 2 to 2. Doesn't make difference. Still, it's going to be not continuous in the open interval minus 2, closed interval minus 2 comma 2. Not continuous, not differentiable. That's enough. About problem number 3, yes, you can work out. Okay. Student, I will tell you one more thing. Look at the last problem of this, problem number 6. Problem number 6 says, examine mean value theorem for the same three problems. Okay, for greatest integer of x only, examine mean value theorem also. Just repeat the same thing what you are going to write for Rolle's theorem. Because in Rolle's theorem, mean value theorem, first and second condition remains the same. You have to check for continuity, you have to check for differentiability. So just repeat the same. So I'll just write down the statement. I know most of you are, I'm just telling verbally, so better to write it. So f of x equal to greatest integer of x is not continuous at any integral points. Between the integers is fine. Between 1 and 2 here it is continuous. But at exactly 1, at exactly 2, at exactly 3, at exactly 4, they are, it's not going to be continuous. Okay. So it is not continuous at any integral point. Therefore, it is not continuous in the closed interval in the closed interval 5, 9. Right. And hence, once it is not continuous, it is not differentiable also, and hence it is not differentiable in the open interval 5, 9. Also, f of 5 is not equal to f of 9. Hence, Rolle's theorem does not satisfy. Fine. So, the same thing what you have written, second problem, you repeat the same, only the interval should be changed. And according to the sixth problem, I should verify mean value theorem for the problems in the second main. That means for the same three problems, you need to verify the Rolle's mean value theorem also. In this, first and second problems are same, but what is the third problem? The third problem is f of x equal to x square minus 1 in the interval, x belongs to the interval 1, 2. Right? I know you're not going to walk out, so it's better for me to walk out this problem. F dash of x, let's keep it here. F dash of x will be 2x. We'll use this later. So what's the first condition? It's a polynomial, hence it's continuous in the closed interval 1, 2. Once it's continuous, it's differentiable in the open interval 1, 2. So after that, the third condition is I have to find f of 1 is equal to f of 2. I should check this. What is f of 1? F of 1 will be 1 square minus 1, f of 2 will be 2 square minus 1. So what is 1 square minus 1? 0, and 2 minus 1 will be 1. Is 0 equal to 1? Certainly not. It fails. F of A is not equal to f of B. Hence, Rolle's theorem is not satisfied. Don't proceed now. Okay, if it fails at any stage, remember the previous two. Actually, it fails to get satisfied in continuity and differentiability itself. Actually, there is no need to solve and get the value show. Okay, verify for f of a equal to f of b. Still, I did it. It's okay. Now, here, as you notice, here f of a is not equal to f of b. So, just simply give a conclusion. Rolle's theorem is not satisfied. Okay, students. Now, let's move on to the problem number 3. I suggest you will take up this later. Not of much importance. Okay. Not the regular one. Okay. So, let's skip this for the time being. We'll see this later on. Okay. Maybe at the end of the session, I will come back to this problem. Most of the times, I will not follow the order which is given there in the exercise or which is given there in the word example. So first, I will try to pick the problems where it's easy for us to understand the concepts. A bit different problems will work out later. Okay. Let's go to the fourth one. Fourth one is verify mean value theorem. The function is given as f of x equal to x square minus 4x minus 3. They said that a is equal to 1, b is equal to 4. So mean value theorem, condition remains the same. F of x is a polynomial, therefore it is continuous in the closed interval 1, 4 and differentiable in the open interval 1, 4. Just repeat the statement for every problem. It's a polynomial, right? So according to the mean value theorem, the second condition or the third condition is f dash of c should be equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. I suggest you, when you are practicing, better to separate practice it separately. So here f dash of x will be 2x minus 4. So f dash of c will be 2c minus 4. And I need to find out something called as f of a and f of b. F of a is 1. So here this will become 1 minus 4 minus 3. So that's going to be minus 6. And f of 4 will be how much? 16 minus 16 minus 3. So it's going to be minus 3. So substitute back here. So f dash of c, 2c minus 4, f of b minus 3 minus of minus 6 by 4 minus 1. All the values I've written. Better solve it in this separate manner and substitute back. So let's simplify it further. 2c minus 4 equal to minus 3 plus 6 by 3. Nothing but 3 by 3 and that's nothing but 1. That means 2c minus 4 equal to 1. Shift minus 4 here. 2c equal to 1 minus 1 plus 4, and that's going to be 5, or c equal to 5 by 2. 5 by 2 is approximately 2.5. Now the thing is, does this exist in the open interval 1, 4? That means, is 2.5 is a number exist in the open interval 1, 4? Certainly 2.4 is a number which lies between 2 and 4. So therefore we can come to a conclusion that c value, whatever we get, exists in the open interval 1, 4. Just notice all the conditions of mean value theorem are verified. It's continuous because it's a polynomial. If it's continuous, it is differentiable. And the third condition, according to third condition, we got the value of c also. So hence all the three conditions are verified. So finally conclude, hence mean value theorem is satisfied. So that's problem number 4. So let's move on to the next one. Again, the next one is, the next one is verify mean value theorem. According to this, problem number 5, f of x equal to x cube minus 5x square minus x, a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 3. You just need to verify the mean value theorem, and you have to repeat the same statements once again. First thing, it's a polynomial, therefore it is continuous in the open interval. Because it's continuous, it's going to be differentiable. Sir, how we got it? No, just go back to the theory in the differentiation part. In the beginning itself of differentiation, I have mentioned every continuous function is going to be differentiable. So you can just check that. And now, once it's continuous, it's differentiable. Please take care. When you're telling continuous, closed interval should be written. And when you're telling it's differentiable, open interval should be mentioned. Fine. Now, continuous differentiability is over. Now, the next one should be f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So, suggestion remains the same. F dash of x equal to 3x square. That means I am differentiating this minus 10x minus 3. So, f dash of c 3c square minus 10c minus 3. F of 1, that is f of a, right? So that's going to be 1 minus 5 minus 3, that will be minus 7. The next is f of 3. F of 3 will be 3 cube minus 5 into 3 square minus 3 into 3. So this will be 27 minus 9, 9 multiplied by 5, 45 minus 9. Okay, so simplify this. So how much this is going to be? This is going to be 50 minus 50. Minus 54, 27. So this is going to be minus 27. So let us substitute. So this will be 3, the left hand side, 3c square minus 10c minus 3 equal to f of b minus 27, f of a minus 7 by 3 minus 1. So this will be minus 27 plus 7 by 2. So how much this will be now? Minus 20 by 2, or it's going to be minus 10. So I suggest you to shift this to left hand side. So on shifting this, 3c square minus 10c minus 3 plus 10 equal to 0. Otherwise, 3c square minus 10c plus 7 equal to 0. And now that's a quadratic equation in terms of c. So I should factorize this. So what we have here is 3c square minus 10c plus 7 equal to 0. So on factorizing, on multiplying the first and the last, I should get 21. So it's going to be minus 7 minus 3. Sorry, it should be plus 21, right? Yeah, fine. That's fine. So on multiplying, I'm going to get 21. On add or subtraction, 10c. So the value of c will be 7 by 3, or c will be equal to 3 by 3. Eliminate here. So 3 is 7 by 3, or c will be equal to 1. Now there exists 2. But what is given to us? The interval what's been mentioned to us was 1 comma 3. That means a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 3. So approximately this value is how much? 2.3 something approximately. Correct, right? And here the value of c equal to c itself. But this one, does not belongs to the open interval. Open interval, you know, actually this one should not, see, the end values are not considered here. Anything between 1 and 3 should be considered. 1 is not a number between 1 and 3. So this does not belongs to the one. What we need to is 2.53 certainly is a number which exists in the open interval 1, 3. So this is what is required for us. Okay, so students, in the 6th one, I already explained you how to solve it. It's just the second problem. The second problem of the NCERT exercise, you have to verify both mean value theorem and Rolle's theorem. Okay, all the things, all the topics, everything, whatever is done for the first time, you're listening. Okay, maybe first time itself, if you're not ready, just practice it and practice. Now you have an advantage, as I said already. Regular class, once the explanation is over, most of the students, if they have doubt also, they will hesitate to come and ask the doubts for clarification. Now just look at that videos. If you're unable to understand, okay, just you can just replay the video once again, go through the explanation once again, and it's easily you can understand, right? So please go through the videos again once or two times. Still it's not clear. After viewing the videos also, still it's not clear. Please come back to us. We'll make sure you'll understand. Okay, that's the end of the chapter called differentiation. Okay, so we have finished the chapter. This is the last topic. We have done everything. So now the rest is on you. You need to sit and practice and learn. Thank you.